The footage has been shot and graded for a sharp, gritty look. The client likes the look, but wishes the talent looked better. We see that the skin is a little too blotchy, and the wrinkles are a little too deep. Can we make him appear better, but still maintain that sharp, gritty look? Retouching isn't always about making someone look like a fashion model. Often it's about managing reality. Do we have the time to do it in DaVinci Resolve? Hi, my name is Paul Wittenberg, and being a Photoshop user, my thoughts went to frequency separation. The idea that you can separate an image into layers based on how frequently a detail changes. Fine details like pores have a higher frequency of change as you look across an image, whereas the general tone of the skin has a very low frequency of change. In this series, I'm going to show how in Resolve you can come closer to the kinds of retouching results achieved in Photoshop or After Effects faster. As I looked for that faster way to do frequency separation in Resolve, whatever I found seemed too complicated. Simplifying it went nowhere until I realized that people were trying to reproduce exactly how it is done in the 8-bit or 16-bit color of Photoshop. Resolve, like most color grading programs, uses 32-bit color. 32-bit is the key. So, let's begin. First, we have to set up our node graph before we can do any actual work on the image. Alt-S to create a new serial node. Alt-L to add a layer mixer. Okay, let's sort this out. Let's call this original. And let's label this blur. Add another serial node, which we'll label subtract. Okay, now line them up. This will help make the finished graph easier to understand. Create another serial node. We'll call detail high. Okay, create another layer mixer. Put this node here, reconnect it, and call it tone. Now we've got all the nodes in place. We're ready to begin the separation. Now we go to actual size so we can have a close look. We go to the blur palette and move the blur up, but only blur out the fine details we want to retain, ironically. Nothing more. This is not random. Frequency separation depends on blending modes, and blending modes work quite a bit differently in 32-bit. So I thought, forget trying to reproduce Photoshop's results. What if I just take the basic principle of subtracting a blurred version of the image from the original unblurred image? We've got the blurred image. So let's go to the first layer mixer. Go to the composite mode and down to subtract. Shift H so that we can have a look at just the detail node. Now, this is what we have created. We have the details separated from the rest of the image, though it doesn't look like what you would see in standard Photoshop methods. Okay, now the final thing, the add mode. If the node tree has been set up properly, this will put the image back to what we had in the beginning. And it has. I've gone back to Photoshop and tried this method there. It works, but only in 32-bit color. Before beginning the actual retouching work, we'll right-click on the image and grab a still so that we now have the grade in its basic form for use later. We'll call it Frequency Separation Basic Setup. We add another serial node and add a power window. Now we have a problem. We are only seeing the part of the tone layer that's inside the power window. Well, that isn't going to work. So what's the solution? We add another node. Now the power window is feeding into the next node, and it is the next node that is feeding into the layer mixer. We'll call the node with the power window cheek, and the other node null. All right, let's move that power window into place, selecting the cheek, adjusting, and feathering. Okay, now we have to track it. Let's track it forward, then track it backwards. And now we'll turn the view off so that we can see what we're doing. We go into 2 in the color wheel palette and go to midtone detail. We pull that down. There. Let's have a closer look. Is that enough? Add a little blurring to smooth it out a bit more. You don't want to use too much blur. Now we turn it off and on. All right. Now we add another serial node. We'll call that the nose. The nose will be a much more complicated power window. We will use Bezier curves. As you create a point, if you hold and pull, you'll pull out handles. And then we connect it. Now let's adjust it. We try to keep it away from the edges so that we don't affect the actual edge detail. I can break the handles so that they don't work together by holding down the Alt key. This is different than if you were on the edit page where you would use the Control key to break the handles. All right, let's soften the edges. When we move in closer, we can see that the softening is a little off. We can adjust these points separately from their original control points. Now we, of course, have to track it. As the face moves and it twitches, the tracking window responds to the movements. All right. Now let's zoom in for a closer look and go again to the mid-tone detail. Bring that down. In some cases, you may only need mid-tone detail. Let's have a look. Maybe a little more blur. We don't want to do too much because the one thing about blur is that it can spread into areas you don't want blurred, which is why, if at all possible, stick to just mid-tone detail. Okay, in the next tutorial, I will fix those wrinkles without using cloning as I go deeper into frequency separation. My name is Paul. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a like. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. For Star Challenge Media, thank you.